Today we are going to discuss about the bit shift operations in the Allen Bradley. So put an input for getting the bit shift blocks. Go to the file shift or sequencer. Here you can see the BSL bit shift left. So place the block and I have to address the input. So go to the inputs i0.0 bar 0, that is my first input. Place here and I'm going to the integer for giving some integer values to the bit address. Okay, placing it to the binary, the radix is changed to binary, and have to get the last number as n710. Have to get the n7 up to n710 integer memories. So close it. First, the file should be n710. The word file n7:10. This is my file. That is the shifting bits are appearing in the n710 memory. So I have to give some control to the block because the blocks doesn't have any proper memory to store some internal values. So I have to give the R60 control. From here you can see the R6 control and the bit address. That is the bit address I am going to place as from N70. This is my bit address. That bit will be shifting to the N710th memory. Okay. During the single toggle. So the length should be 1. That is the number of bits should be shifting towards left after time. So go to verify and to download. Yes. And we're going to go to run it. Yes. Before toggling, we have to monitor some values. So go to the N7 integer. Here we are going to give the N70, the bit address, as 1. The shifting operation will be happens in the N710. So let's see. On the toggle, the N710, the first value is 1. On every toggle, that value should be shifted to left. Okay, like this. On every toggle, the value is shifting to left. Okay, on the next toggle, you can see the values are shifting. So hope you understand the bit shift operations. You have to try the BSR. This is the right word shifting. BSR blocks also. Thank you.